Go.
The boys are back in town, and these 13 things about another 48 hours are going to sound the alarm. That was a prison pun, just in case you missed it. Number 13. According to Brion James, around 50 minutes were cut from the final work print until the release version. James said this in an interview. Total Recall came out a week before Another 48 Hours that summer. It made $25 million, became the number one movie in the country, and the studio panicked because they had invested a lot in the 48 Hours films. But they felt that at well over 2 hours that the movie might be too much. My stuff was in there until 1 week before the film opened. That is when they cut 25 minutes out of the movie a week before it opened. It went from around 140 down to 95 minutes. They said, cut out all the behavior, action, comedy. I lost every major scene I had. That's the last time I ever cared about a movie because I went to the press screening and it was like getting kicked in the stomach, seeing what is not there. I was the third lead and now I look like a dressed extra. All the stuff that they had in the setup, stuff in the trailer, and all those scenes were gone.
Number 12. Character actor Frank McRae was cast as Hayden, Nick Nolte's boss, the same part he played in 48 Hours. His part was almost completely cut from this picture. If you look closely in one of the shots in the police precinct, McRae appears on camera for a few seconds. He was uncredited for the role.
Number 11. Reportedly, Eddie Murphy's paycheck for the first 48 Hours film was $450,000, while Nick Nolte's salary was $1 million. For the sequel, however, Nick Nolte got $3 million, while Eddie Murphy received $7 million.
Number 10. Nick Nolte appears heavier than usual in the role because when shooting started, he was still carrying the weight he gained for Q&A.
Number 9. Eddie Murphy actually wrote the story using the fictitious name of Fred Broughton for story credit.
Number 8. An early draft of the screenplay was shown in synopsis form in the book The Films of Eddie Murphy by Edward Gross. It revealed some interesting details that didn't make it into the final film, such as Jack being in a new relationship with a female cop who was willing to plant a gun at the racetrack to clear his name, and Jack's new Cadillac would have suffered the same fate as Reggie's Porsche, which prompted Reggie to make a joke about where Jack got the car alarms installed.
Number 7. The opening sequence is an homage to the opening sequence in Once Upon a Time in the West.
Number 6. When Reggie is calling his old friends to try and borrow money, one of the men he calls is named Willie Biggs. In the original screenplay for the movie, Willie Biggs was the original name of Reggie Hammond. Eddie Murphy requested that the name be changed because he thought it was a generic black name.
Number 5. The boys are back in town phrase was used in the main tagline for this film. Similarly, the promotional blurb for the first film, 48 Hours, started with the same wording. This was also the name of a song written specifically for that film. The track was never released when that movie came out and was never available on CD until the year 2000. For the sequel, though, the original song was heard at the end of the film and wasn't included on this film's album either.
Number 4. The pen with the undressing woman that Cates is seen playing with when he was clearing out his desk also appears in another Walter Hill Nick Nolte film, Extreme Prejudice.
Number 3. Because of the violent shootout in the hotel lobby sequence in the first film, according to the book Walter Hill, Last Man Standing by Patrick McGilligan, director Walter Hill was told he would never work for Paramount again. Hill did, though, as he directed this sequel for Paramount.
Number 2. The film grossed more at the U.S. box office than its predecessor and made $72.7 million from foreign markets for a total of $153.5 million. However, this was considered a box office disappointment, and because the film was so costly, profits were minimized.
Number 1. Eddie Murphy accused Paramount of not spending enough on advertising and changing the release date. Paramount counter-alleged that Murphy did not spend enough time promoting the film. This led to tension in the long-running relationship between Murphy and Paramount. And that was the 13 things you probably didn't know about Another 48 Hours. Thank you for